You remember so far we had natural numbers? Let's just summarize that. So we had the natural numbers, and I'll just give the short symbol. Oh, another color. N. And it's this double bar, yeah? Natural numbers. Then we had integers, z. Yeah, natural numbers only positive, integers positive and negative, countable numbers. Then we had the rational numbers, q, for quotient, which is written as one number divided by another number. Yeah. And then we had the real numbers. The real numbers are mostly those numbers that have infinitely long decimals, but they contain all the others as well. Yeah. And then we had the complex numbers, and the complex numbers consisted of two parts, of a real component and an imaginary component. And one thing for complex you have to remember always is I times I is minus 1. So these were the number systems we had so far. And if you remember, complex numbers consisted of the real component and the imaginary. And they are written like a number, say 7.3 plus 2.1i. Yeah. So the I is the imaginary component, the one without the I is the real component. Now, all those should be quite familiar to you if you have done those previous lessons. If some of them is not quite clear, just go back now, look at that again, and then come back here and continue this one. Yeah, it will be good to get really clear about all that. So what we'll do now is this. We'll go deeper into this, the real numbers. And whatever we find there will also apply to the complex, but we won't mention it each time. So whatever we apply now applies to the real component here, and also to the imaginary component. So in the real numbers, you remember we had this, how many rational numbers, how many integer or natural numbers are contained in the real numbers? Yeah, let's write that question again. How many, let's say a percentage, how many rational numbers that includes the integers and the natural, how many rational numbers are contained in R? And when I say R with that double line, I mean the set of all real numbers. So how many are contained in there? Of course, very simple answer. Infinite amount. There are infinitely many rational numbers. And so an infinite amount of rational numbers is in the real numbers. But now, as a percentage, please. As a percentage. How much percent of the real numbers is rational numbers? And the answer is, that may surprise you, let's not go away too much. The answer is, it is 0% rational. Yeah, 0% of the Qs. And it's 100% of the real. Why is that? 0%, there are still infinitely many, but if you look at it close enough, it amounts to 0%. Yeah, that means this infinity of the real is so much bigger that the rest appears like 0%. Yeah, and we call that the cardinality. Mathematicians call it the cardinality of number sets. So the cardinality of the natural integer and rational numbers, we could have said only the rational because the rational contains those others. The cardinality is called a countable infinity. Countable infinity. Why? So that's a countable infinity. Why? Because with the say the integer numbers, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. You can count forever. You never arrive at infinity. But you, so to say, count with a certain speed to come towards infinity. Yeah? You count tuck, 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 tuck. And at the end of it is infinity. But you sort of imagine if you would count forever, you would arrive at infinity. Therefore, it's called, strangely enough, countable. It's not countable. But if you imagine you would count forever, you would come to that infinity. Now, the real number, real numbers are quite a different thing. So, with the real numbers, it's called a continuum. Continuum. And they are also infinite, infinitely many, yeah. But if you start try to count between the first and the second, you have to stop already counting because there are infinitely many in between there. Yeah. You can't even attempt to count to that infinity. So therefore, this is a higher infinity. Yeah. And they have also mathematical abbreviations. These sizes of infinity, you could say. Yeah. And they are called the cardinality. That's the cardinality. And the cardinality of the countable infinity is Aleph null. So it's a Hebrew letter that's written like that. And it's Aleph null, zero, yeah? And the cardinality of the continuum is Aleph one. Aleph 1, yeah? So, how much more infinite is Aleph 1 compared to Aleph 0? It's infinitely bigger than that first infinity. Because between each step, yeah, if you look into this, each step in there is an infinity. Yeah? And then you have that infinitely often as you count, countably to this, yeah? So, between each one of the countable numbers, say each one of the rationals, say these are two rationals, between each one of the two rationals is an infinite amount of reals. Yeah? And for that reason, they are no more countable, yeah? So, you could also say uncountable. Uncountable. The other ones are also uncountable, so it's a bit of a mind game here with mathematics. Yeah. So, but they call them uncountable. Yeah. I mean, no mathematician can count the countable infinity. Yeah. It's just that you can't even imagine coming to that infinity by counting. Yeah. So. That's what that means. So this is cardinality. How many uncountable continuous infinities are there? Exist? Yeah. Now that will surprise you again, probably. How many higher infinities exist? And that has been proven mathematically. Higher infinities beyond Aleph 1, yeah? Beyond Aleph 1 exist. Question, answer, infinitely many. Infinitely many. So, it can be proven that if there exists one higher infinity, there must exist Aleph 2, Aleph 3, etc. infinitely many. Yeah. So, the end of the game is infinity multiplied by infinity infinitely often. So, that's about the highest infinity you can imagine. Marvelous. You know, once you get into that, it's hard to get out again. So, we'll have some more applications. So, we didn't come to that next number system, but it was important to look at the size of those infinities. Yeah, and it has to do with your state of consciousness. And we'll have a lecture about that, how those various infinities relate to your state of consciousness. And the higher evolved your state of consciousness, the more you become aware of the various higher infinities, and they become very real to you. So all those are just real numbers. Then see you again next time.